Hey everyone! Today we'll be looking at a motherboard from the Republic of Gamers lineup by ASUS, the ROG Crosshair 8 Extreme. If you're on the lookout for the absolute highest end, the flagship of an AM4 motherboard by ASUS, the ROG Crosshair 8 Extreme is your answer. Let's get cracking! As always, let's get started with the packaging. This is a high-end motherboard and therefore ASUS has spared no expense for the quality of the packaging materials. The entire package is really heavy and comes in at around 5 kg in terms of weight. Color scheme wise, ASUS guns for the usual black and red colorway that has come to be associated with the Republic of Gamers lineup. Let's set aside the board for the moment so that we can inspect the contents of the box. Starting with this section right here, we see that ASUS has included a ROG fan controller that allows users to add 6 additional fan headers, 6 addressable RGB headers, as well as 2 thermal sensor headers. We'll take a closer look at this later in the video. We also get a very premium looking and feeling ROG screwdriver. The finish of this screwdriver is just sublime and cool to the touch. Very nice. On top of this, we get a ROG Clavis DAC dongle. We'll talk a little bit more about this dongle later in the video. Finally, we get a ROG DIMM.2 module that allows you to add 2 additional M.2 drives to the board via a slot that is specially provisioned on the Crosshair 8 Extreme for this purpose. Again, we'll spend some time later in this video to have a closer look at it. In this section here, we get an ASUS Wi-Fi antenna, seeing as this board comes with built-in Wi-Fi 6E. Moving on to this section underneath, we see that ASUS has included some strips of 3M mounting tape for the ROG fan controller, an addressable RGB cable to be used with the ROG fan controller, 2 1-4 fan splitter cables. A RGB extension cable. A pack of thermistor cables. An external power cable for the ROG fan controller. And a Q connector that allows you to simplify the installation of your front panel headers. And we're still not done with the accessories. Moving over to this section right here, we get a sleeve that contains some printed literature. Starting with a ROG fan controller manual, the manual for the Clavis DAC USB dongle, a thank you card from ASUS, the motherboard manual, and to round things off, a sheet of ROG stickers. Beneath this divider, we get a thumb drive that contains drivers and utilities. A 1-3 addressable RGB splitter cable. a USB input cable that is to be used together with the ROG fan controller, a total of 6 SATA 3 cables that are in a braided style as opposed to the usual plastic coated cables, a ROG keychain, and a ROG graphics card holder that props up heavy graphics cards to prevent sag. Finally, in this section right here, we get 4 packs of M2 screws. Now, 2 of them are for the ROG DIMM.2 module and the other 2 are for use with the M2 slots that are directly mounted on the board. We also do get some M2 rubber pads that add additional height clearance, and a very nice looking metal case badge in the shape of the ROG logo. And that is the last of the mountain of accessories included with this board. I'm not kidding when I say it's probably the most comprehensive list of kit that I have ever seen come included with a motherboard. With that, onto the board itself. For the board aesthetics, we see that ASUS has gone for a predominantly black palette with some splashes of mirror finishes to round up the look. As with premium motherboards, ASUS doesn't skimp on the amount of heat sinks that come included with the Crosshair 8 Extreme. We've got a whole bunch of metal on the back of the board as well. The board also features RGB LEDs in these areas, and they go a long way in adding visual interest. We've also got a 2-inch live dash OLED display that allows you to display device statistics such as CPU temperature, frequency, or even a custom animated GIF. All in all, as a flagship AM4 motherboard, this board certainly looks the part. In terms of power delivery, the ROG Crosshair 8 Extreme comes with a premium Texas Instruments 18+2 setup that is accompanied by microfine alloy chokes and 10K premium capacitors. This board is most certainly going to meet the needs of even the most extreme overclockers out there. In the memory department, the board comes with 4 DDR4 slots with support for the DDR4 5000 standard and 128GB of RAM. The RAM slots feature ASUS's Optimum Tree technology with proprietary memory trace layout tweaks that can potentially improve the performance of your RAMs. You'll note that on the right, we get an additional slot. Now this is the very slot that you would install the ROG DIMM.2 module should you wish to add 2 additional M2 slots to the board. Above the RAM slots is a series of voltage readout points that ASUS calls Probit, where you will be able to measure metrics such as CPU V-core voltage, DRAM voltage, and so on using a multimeter. We also get a Q-code LED display and a QLED feature that allow you to troubleshoot PC issues. ASUS has also included a start button that allows you to power up the PC, as well as a flex key button that serves as a reset button but can also be reconfigured to do other things such as turning on the RGB lighting. Do note that the board comes with an additional 6-pin power connector right here, which provides additional juice to the PCIe X16 slots and enables power delivery 3.0 for the front panel USB 3.2 Gen 2x2 ports. On the topic of front panel USB, we get a USB 3.2 Gen 2x2 front panel header, a USB 3.2 Gen 2 front panel header, as well as 2 USB 3.2 Gen 1 headers. For storage, the board comes with 6 SATA 3 ports and 3 PCIe 4.0 X4 M2 slots mounted on the main board itself. Do note that due to CPU PCIe lane limitations, there will be some form of trade-off. For example, the second PCIe X16 slot on this board will be disabled if you were to populate the second and third M2 slots, and the first PCIe slot will drop to X8 mode, as per the screenshot from the motherboard manual. As mentioned earlier, the Crosshair 8 Extreme comes with a pretty cool feature, the ROG DIMM.2 module that allows you to add two additional PCIe 4.0 X4 M2 slots via the special slot that's provided on the board. And the thing to note here is that the bandwidth for these two slots comes directly from the X570 chipset, which means that you do not sacrifice any functionality when these two M2 slots are in use. Moving on to the expansion slots, the Crosshair 8 Extreme comes with two PCIe 4.0 X16 slots with the ASUS Safe Slot feature, which reinforces the slots, as well as a PCIe 3.0 X1 slot. I'd like to spend some time to highlight some interesting high-end overclocking features that can be found at the bottom of the board, starting with this LN2 mode jumper that is targeted at folks out there intending to do liquid nitrogen cooling, where this feature allows the board to boot with extremely low temperatures. We also do get a V-latch switch that allows hardcore enthusiasts to measure the true Vmin and Vmax of the CPU's V-core without needing an oscilloscope. Next to it is a slow mode switch, which allows you to slow down your processor during liquid nitrogen benchmarking to ensure system stability. We also get a safe boot button, which allows one to apply safe settings to the BIOS while retaining one's overclock settings, thereby allowing you to, say, modify any settings that may have caused the boot failure in the first place. Next to it is a retry button, which allows overclockers to force a system reboot in quick succession using the same settings. And finally, we get a BIOS switch that allows you to toggle between the two BIOS chips that come included with this board. Pretty handy, especially if you want to load different BIOS settings in a jiffy. The board's audio is powered by the high-end Realtek ALC4082 audio codec, and this is accompanied by an ESS Saber 9018Q2C DAC chip. In terms of internet connectivity, the Crosshair 8 Extreme comes with dual Ethernet ports, with one port powered by Marvell's Aquantia AQC113CS controller offering 10 gigabit Ethernet support, and the other port offering 2.5 gigabit Ethernet courtesy of Intel's i225V. Wi-Fi 6E is built in with this board and is powered by Intel's AX210. While we're on the topic of audio, the included Clavis DAC dongle is a cool accessory to have and can be used with both a PC or a mobile phone to spice up your audio experience. This switch right here allows you to toggle between device types. Now, the dongle connects to your device via a USB Type-C connector, and on the other end is a 3.5mm audio jack that you would use to connect your earphones or speakers with. In terms of fan and pump headers, the Crosshair 8 Extreme comes with a whopping 8 of them, which are located in these areas of the board. Also included is a water block header, which allows you to connect sensors to monitor the flow rate and water leak signals of your third-party monoblocks. We also get these liquid cooling system headers located in this part of the board. For RGB support, the board comes with three addressable RGB headers, as well as a standard 12-volt RGB header, which are located in these regions of the board. If you choose to use the included ROG Fan Controller module, you will gain access to 6 additional fan headers, 6 additional addressable RGB headers, as well as 2 thermal sensor connectors. Onto the rear I/O ports, the Crosshair 8 Extreme comes with a BIOS flashback button which allows you to update the BIOS without a CPU or RAM install, a clear CMOS button, 2 DisplayPort in ports for Thunderbolt 4, Wi-Fi antenna connectors, 8 USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-A ports, accompanied by a 10 Gigabit Ethernet port, a 2.5 Gigabit Ethernet port, as well as 2 Thunderbolt 4 USB Type-C ports, and this is rounded off by the standard array of audio jack connectors. In conclusion, the ROG Crosshair 8 Extreme is truly deserving of its title as ASUS's flagship motherboard for the AM4 platform. This is well and truly a feature-packed motherboard with all the modern features that any hardcore enthusiast could ever ask for, especially if you're an extreme overclocker intending to do a spot of liquid nitrogen cooling. And I would expect no less, seeing as this board is currently going for around $1,500 in Singapore, or $799 thereabouts on places such as Amazon and Newegg, which puts it right smack in very pricey territory, alright? One thing to note though is that this motherboard can be considered to be part of the final wave of X570 motherboard releases by major manufacturers, owing to the fact that AMD's AM5 platform, as well as the much vaunted AMD Ryzen 7000 series of processors, are due to be launched in the second half of 2022. So this is something that you will have to take into consideration, especially if you're intending to splash out for a money-no-object AMD PC build. With that, thank you so much for watching. Do like and subscribe if you've enjoyed this video, and I hope to catch you guys around the next time.